Thank you, Mr. President. I agree with much of what Senator Lovelace said about the future that we want to pass on to our children. And it's a future where, you know, we have communities that are thriving and we're paying attention to the environment. This bill doesn't do any of that. What this bill does is add an additional layer on top of a piece of legislation, the Growth Management Act, that was instituted how many years ago now? I think 1994. And the Growth Management Act has consistently added costs to the housing. It's artificially restricted the amount of land, driving up the cost of the land cost. It is allowed for the institution of impact fees, which prior to that, cities and counties, Mr. President, used to put in roads and put in infrastructure because they wanted housing developments. They wanted somebody to develop that land so that they would get the benefit of that property taxes. And now you got to make those new people pay. When that happens, the value of existing housing goes up, and so does their property taxes. What we're actually talking about here, when we talk about Washington's impact on the environment, is 0.00025%. That is the entire impact of the state of Washington on the world climate. 2.5 to 3 days of what China does. So what we do in 1 year, China does in 2.5 to 3 days. We would be much better on this floor, Mr. President, to pass a resolution and encourage China to just reduce their carbon output by some minuscule amount, which would be equal to everything that we're doing in the entire year in Washington State. We hear a lot of talk about transit. We want to encourage transit. We want to encourage this. Well, one way to get people to take transit is to increase congestion. As congestion increases, the thought is that transit ridership will increase. Look at the level of congestion that people are willing to take now, Mr. President. And I argue that if you did actually relieve congestion with transit, because that's the purpose, that's the selling point. If we spend $54 billion on sound transit, we will relieve congestion. If you did relieve congestion, Mr. President, people would then drive because roads wouldn't be congested. There is a balance. There is a level of congestion that people are willing to take. My daughter used to work in Kent. She used to get on the bus, hour and 10 minutes to get to work in Kent. You could drive there in 10 minutes. Why? Because the bus stopped every 300 feet to pick people up. But now it takes an hour and 10 minutes to get there. People could drive, even with congestion, they could still get home faster. When we are on the cusp of a technological change, 20 years ago I was in the House and I made the statement that 20 years from now we're all going to be holograms. We're not even going to be here. During the COVID, I was only off by one dimension. We're here two dimensions instead of three, right? We are on the cusp of a technological change. We are on the cusp of autonomous vehicles. How many people are going to be taking transit if I could get in your car and say, bring me to Olympia? And I'm reading a book or watching a movie or doing whatever. When those technological changes happen, that's when it's going to naturally occur. We're on a cusp of hydrogen vehicles, which I'm really excited about. I'm trying to encourage Ford to give a hydrogen Mustang, Mr. President, right? And since one of the hydrogen-producing facilities is Wenatchee, the exhaust from the tailpipe of a hydrogen vehicle is water. But if we could get that exhaust to be apple juice, Mr. President, we would be in a real plus in this state. What is the impact on climate that we are having? 48 pages of legislation, 48 more pages of legislation to address something that we are currently at about something like 72% clean energy in this state. Let's just round that off to 75%. That means in order to get that extra 25%. Okay, so we're already at 75%, 72% clean energy. To get that little bit extra, if we went to 100% clean energy, we would then reduce the impact on climate in this, in the entire world, by 0.000625%. That's what we're talking about with 48 pages of legislation and the impact that this is going to have on those million housing units that everybody wants, that affordable housing that everybody wants. This is just an additional layer, additional costs, and needless to say, Mr. President, I would urge a no vote. Thank you.